and Red Star Belgrade in blue. Maccabi, four times winners of this Phillips International Trophy. And Red Star, a very powerful squad too. But Maccabi, they have a very powerful outfit indeed. Amongst them, Mickey Berkowitz, who wears the number nine, their ball handler. Then we've got Kevin McGee and Lee Johnson, two new Americans who proved so effective so far in the tournament. For Red Star, they have a new player wearing number 13, just flown in especially for the final, Milicevic, at 6'10". He's been representing Yugoslavia in the Balkan Games. He's joined by Radovic and Avdija, the number 15, 11 and 15 respectively. And Red Star have the first possession. Number 7 on the far side is Jokanovic. Number 5, Aleksic. Number 14, Milivoja. There's the new man in the middle, the big centre brought in specially. He's just scored his first points of this Phillips tournament. Milicevic. Two very good points from Lee Johnson. And if Red Star are going to do well in this final, they're going to have to contain that man. 6'10". Doesn't have the athletic physique, but he sure can jump. Stratenovic on the top. Milivoja, Stratenovic, Aleksic. Aleksic is in. Aleksic. The crowd here filling out as the excitement begins. Oh, from both sides now, Johnson. ...20 minutes of actual play time for each half. There's 18 minutes and 40 seconds left in the first half. That was nice. No basket. The foul occurred before the basket.
Nice drive through here, and then there's a foul on Lee Johnson, reaching in, trying to get the basketball.
Well, Johnson playing a significant part in the early stages of this game with those two baskets and then collecting his first foul. Well, if the performance of the English teams is to be taken into account here, Maccabi is certainly beatable. And that's against the defender, Alexander Aleksic, wearing the number 5 vest. And Mickey Berkowitz, who's usually very successful from the free throw line, on the free throw line, has his opportunity of two free shots here. Fouled in the act of attempting a basket. 1 point for each of the free shots. So, there's the early scoreline, 6-4. The four times champions in the lead. Jokanovic on the top, and Stratanovic now. The big men moving. Very much a rotation attack here. And the Maccabi players almost rebounding each other out of it there. Aresti, Silva. Johnson. Oh, yes. What a fine player Johnson is.
Very athletic performance by Lee Johnson. Reaches in over the top to put that ball in.
And he's reaching over players at 6'9" and more. Very tight defence, man-to-man defence from Maccabi. Checked away. The request for basket interference denied. Silva. Oh, what a pace this game started at. Aleksic. Nice play by Stratenovic. 8-6. The big number 13 for Maccabi, Kevin McGee. 24 points in the match against Manchester. Johnson. Oh, a steal. And the Yugoslavs with just four men down court with Milicevic still repairing his shoe at the far end of the court. And whilst he was down the other end, they scored 2 points. And he casually looks up, he still hasn't got back in, now he's there. Berkovic defended by Jokanović. Aresti defended by Stretanović. A travelling violation there against Kevin McGee. Almost looked as though the referee, Mr. Kotlieber, was going to award a charging foul, but he changed it to travelling. I don't think the man's happy as it is, but because he's lost possession. Stretanović. Man-to-man tight. Luis Silva. Berkovic. And that's a defensive foul, adjudged by Mr. Kotlieber. It's against Stretanović. Let's have a look at that if we can. Well, the player must be in position soon enough to be considered for the foul to go the other way. Second foul on to Stretanović.
It's interesting to see the different styles of the teams. The Yugoslavs are satisfied in shooting from the outside, whereas Maccabi are forcing the ball inside to Lee Johnson and Kevin McGee.
Well, Maccabi don't enjoy teams running at them. They like to get set up in the defences so that they can bring their big men rebounding machine into play. But they are being hustled and charged at the moment. Red Star obviously watched the Manchester game yesterday. Berkovic. Oh, well taken out there by Stretanović. 2 points to Aleksić.
That was lovely play from the point guard. There he does, fakes, then a nice pass in, and a relatively simple layup.
Well, the assist down one end and the foul down the other to Johnson. And that's his second foul. And there's the scoreline, 11 to Maccabi, 10 to Red Star Belgrade. 15 minutes and 23 seconds left in this first half of this final. Well, very aggressive piece of rebounding there by McGee. Johnson. Filicevic initiating the break once again, and that's a nice play by Jokanović. And I just sense that this Yugoslav side, having moved ahead, has really begun to bring up the pace and to play the game that Maccabi don't enjoy. Silva. Berkovic. Berkovic defended by Jokanović. And that's a foul against Zoran Stretanović. That's his third. He wears the number 8 vest of Red Star Belgrade.
It's not very often you see Maccabi Tel Aviv being fast-breaked on themselves. They like to fast-break against other teams. They don't particularly like it themselves. Excellent play from the Yugoslavs.
Well, Maccabi always, the front runners always rely on the fact that their big men are going to steal the ball, and they set off early on the break. The referee, Hugh Richardson of the United States, just administering the ball there to Luis Silva. Aresti. Silva. Johnson. McGee looking to block out for that rebound position and not needing it. 11 points now to Lee Johnson. Almost a steal there, and Silva defending Aleksić very tight indeed. The big man showing real versatility. Berkovic on the break. He's in this time.
And that's just why Mickey Berkovic is one of the best guards in Europe. What a beautiful move there. One against two, scores the basket.
Jokanović. And the foul, I think, against Mickey Berkovic. Or McGee, rather. That's his first. McGee wearing the number 13 vest. Oh! Oh, my goodness me. And they had two errors. One almost, and then a disaster, giving possession to the Israeli champions. And look at that. They weren't able to take advantage of it. Oh, what a jumping player Johnson is. McGee, and there's a foul.
This match is being played at a furious pace, and at the moment both teams are making simple mistakes in handling the ball. They've really got to slow down and take control of the ball, but the pace is absolutely exhilarating at the moment.
Aleksic collected his second foul there. And Kevin McGee from Irvine University scores his first points of the game. There, Maccabi just as 5 points ahead. Stratenovic, just a couple of turnovers, lost possessions, that is, prevented Red Star from maintaining them the rhythm of play. Oh, well supported by Luis Silva. Silva, the big number 12.
Here is the missed shot from Kevin Meagher. There's Lou Silva following up just to put the ball in the basket.
Stratenovic and the big centre taking the shot. And Milicevic a bit rusty. Silva, oh, marvellous, marvellous pass in. And there's a foul again against Aleksic, and surely there must be a timeout. And I think he, the coach to Red Star Belgrade has called the timeout. That's Ranko Zarevica. Zarevica, who was the coach to the Yugoslav Olympic team in Moscow in 1980 when they won the gold medal. So his experience, well needed now. He certainly has problems of discipline with his team at the moment.
When we are going to the break, find the open man. I prefer that you will not dribble the ball. Give it to Moti, that you will pass. Now, you came here, pass all inside, all to the corner and cut. As we find Kevin twice, okay? Look, not to lose balls and not to dribble behind a small player.
And here now the Israeli team are going to force the ball inside to Kevin McGee and Lee Johnson, who really are starting to dominate the Yugoslav players close to the basket, where they're getting fouled and they're getting Maccabi further ahead.
Well, it's interesting to see now that Avdija has come on to court, the number 15 for Red Star Belgrade. Avdija, who has done well in this tournament so far. It is who initiates the movement for Red Star. Stratenovic, number 14, Milivoja. Aleksic under pressure from Silva. Jokanovic trapped in the corner, but attempting the drive. Avdija. Now, Avdija achieved that on numerous occasions in previous rounds, and the coach went with the new but international player to begin with, and it didn't quite pay off. But he may well bring him in again later. But Avdija playing well. And he fouls there, putting Kevin McGee under pressure. Long, long pass. Oh, on that occasion, Milicevic there sitting out and waiting his next opportunity. A nice play from Milivoja. And the combination between Milivoja and Avdija is going to be crucial, particularly in the control of the backboards at both ends, really. Just 11 minutes and 30 seconds left, as you see, in this first half. 20 to Maccabi and 16 to Red Star Belgrade. And there's Kevin McGee collecting his second foul, the number 13. The yellow vest of Maccabi Tel Aviv. Twice former European champions, Maccabi. Lots and lots of experience, and so often if they get into tight corners at the end of games, they have that experience to call upon. Avdija. Milivoja and Stratenovic. chance of Dia. Jokanović. Aleksic. Silva forcing Aleksic to the side. Oh, check out there by Johnson.
This just shows the jumping ability of Lee Johnson. The ball's put up there and he just knocks the ball away. Very agile shot.
He had four complete blockouts of that kind in the last round. In the semi-final. Abdia. Well, I think you can see already how important the two new Americans are to the Maccabi side. They lost Earl the Pearl Williams, but they've got some tremendous replacements here. Jokanović, the rebounder. Silva. And remember, they've still got Olsi Perry to come. Berkovits. Well, that's the fast break initiated, and Berkovits was off way, way in advance.
Lovely pass from 6'8" Lou Silva to Mickey Berkovits, who lays the ball in.
That's the fast break at its best. Seven team fouls now against Red Star, and errors creeping in. Well, that possession goes to Red Star. Jokanović pushes it in, attempts the break. Doesn't... Oh! A little too far. Silva. Well, this is one of the fastest games we've had in this Phillips tournament. It's... we've had some tremendous basketball. 4 points to Luis Silva, but the margin now 8 points. Abdia. It's a bad spell for Red Star. And a foul on number seven, Jokanović. And Olsi Perry, the 6'10", number eight for Maccabi Tel Aviv, just preparing himself coolly to come on to court. And when you're playing as well as they are, and they're still able to bring a man like Perry on and give Lou Silva a rest, well, that shows the depth.
The Maccabi defense this year is so much more aggressive than in previous years, and they're forcing the Yugoslavs to make lots of mistakes. Yugoslavs must slow the ball down and get better shots at the basket so that they can get back into this game.
I'm just looking at the Red Star lineup. Nikolic is back in, number six, and Karadzic, number nine. Avdija is still there. And so is Milivoša, the two big men who've got to create the outlet pass potential to initiate the break. They must get in to control the backboards. Jokanović pushing the ball out to Karadzic. Well, well played, Oresti. But the Yugoslavs desperate not to let this margin go any greater. Berkovic, oh! Oh, Mickey Berkovic collects 2 points. Well, he hasn't missed a shot yet, Mickey Berkovic. 10 points to his credit. And look at the margin, 28-16. The outside shooting not working at all. And I think there has to be a change in policy. They've got to get inside or get the break going. And the coach must be very worried. At last, two vital points, and they go down to Jokanović. Nikola Jokanović, 6 points to him. Now, Resti, just for the moment, slowing things down, calling the play. It's a 1-3-1 attack at the moment. And Perry, very, very lazy, but got the ball at the end. Oh, Johnson. Lee Johnson, professional with the Detroit Pistons. Lots of European basketball experience, moves on to 13 points. That is better from Abdia.
It's a very strong move by Avdija, right through the middle of the zone, powers his way up to the basket.
Amora Hayaresti, almost 70 full international games to his credit. And Lee Johnson is proving an impossible man to defend against at the moment. 12 points the margin. That's not a tremendous margin yet. That's better. Jokanović, 2 points, and here comes a timeout. And I suppose Red Star really must bring themselves back into a disciplined game of basketball.
The two things that that he probably wants to make sure of are, one, that they must stop Lee Johnson. He's scoring from outside, and now he's scoring close to the basket as well. They must try and stop him getting the basketball. And the other thing is, they must get good shots down the other end. At the moment, McGee in particular, he can ignore the rebounds, and the Israelis are fast breaking down the other end. They must slow things down and get good shots close to the basket.
Well, the Israelis must be quite pleased with the way they're playing at the moment. They've got so many big men at 6'9 and over that they can sort of substitute and then take them off and substitute again. And they really don't lose any ability in doing that. So the intensity of the game can be maintained for far longer. And Luis Silva's back on now. And we've got Johnson off being given a rest. Well-earned rest too, with the buffer of that 10-point margin. McGee into the corner, Berkovic again. This time it's a little bit short, Karidzic. The fast break is almost working. That was off the foot of Kevin McGee, so the possession will go to Red Star. 6 minutes and 34 seconds left in this first half. And there's no penetration at the moment for the Red Star team. There's no player able to get in unless closely attended by a Maccabi player. And that was illegal pressure from Luis Silva, number 12. That's his first foul. Luis Silva has been 9 years with the team. All Israeli international, of course. American-born lawyer. Very talented. Then really not allowing the shot to go unpressured, and that was well taken by Nikolic. It is interesting, as Oresti brings the ball in, to note that the top scorer for Red Star Belgrade, Radovic, hasn't been brought on yet. He's the number 11. I must be very worried about control in terms of the big men, but I think Radovic's shooting ability is needed. And as I say that, he's just being moved. Look at that.
That was a beautiful pass from Lou Silva, left-handed pass, and Kevin McGee just reaches over the top and dunks the ball home for 2 points.
And in doing that, he's injured himself. He came down on his ankle and twisted his ankle, and if he can't play any further part in this game, that will be a great loss. He's going off for treatment with the physiotherapist, and Radovic is now coming on. Radovic is on, the number 11. And Kevin McGee leaves for treatment. Now, here's Radovic. 30 points in the game against Kingston in the semi-final. Now let's see if his shooting ability will make the difference. Lee Johnson back on, of course, for Maccabi in place of Kevin McGee. Yes, that's Nikolic. Now, if Nikolic and Radovic can get their shooting together, then Red Star do stand a chance. Oh, Olsi Perry. 6'10", takes the margin to 10. 5 minutes left in this first half. Zoran Radovic. Karadzic, defended by Berkovic. And that's a foul on Berkovic, that's his first. Mickey Berkovic, the number 9 for Maccabi. 16 fouls now against Maccabi Tel Aviv, the number of fouls against Red Star Belgrade is much greater. Ooh. Full international is the man taking the shots. First points of the game. There must be some pressure from the defence. They mustn't allow the penetration, but Silva's free underneath the backboard. And there he receives it. Now, he's good at that shot from the corner. Time and time again, he pops them in from the corners. And he can't be allowed the freedom to do it. 6 points to him, but it's what it does to the overall margin that counts, with just 4 minutes and 20 seconds left. Nikolic, Radovic. The control of the backboards, as we said at the beginning, absolutely vital, and it's being won by Maccabi, even though that one was taken by Milivoja. Nice. Radovic. Radovic is in. And it was Lou Silva, the man to foul him.
Lovely bounce pass to Radovic, who lays the ball up and is fouled by Lou Silva.
And there'll be a bonus shot, fouled in the act of shooting, even though the basket went in. That was 2 points, and now he gets a chance at a further 1 point as a penalty for that foul. Oh! Carried back to Aresti. Aresti initiating all the plays, allowing Berkovic more freedom along the side of the court for those long, long shots. Three-pointer. The shots, of course, from outside the arc. 3 points. Silva. Johnson. Oh! 43-29, this margin, 3 minutes and 27 seconds left in this first half. And this really is a dominant piece of play by Maccabi.
Maccabi are so entertaining when they run the ball down the court. There is a beautiful pass from behind his head to Berkovic, who got the ball into Johnson, who just scored right close to the basket.
And everybody to move over this stick. And the other side, if you can break, okay. If no, stay the game. Stay the game also. He pulled from Messi to the corner and drive in. The first shot was bad after that. Okay. When you see that Mickey or Lou is taking the shot from the corner, you are not in the rebound position. Get back. But don't stay. Mickey or Xavi. But Takadu.
The Israeli coach there saying that if they don't have the fast break, then they slow the ball down and get a good shot. Get the ball into Olsi Perry and Lee Johnson. And if not, then they run a shot for Mickey Berkovic, who's playing extremely well at the moment. But at the moment, they're looking to fast break the ball down, and the Yugoslavs must get back into the game before half-time.
Well, number 10, Bogosayev, is on for Red Star. He's the man to take the shot, but has the ball snatched from him by Johnson. Silva. Silva in full flight, 2 more points. 8 points to him. And just news of Kevin McGee, who was injured just a little while ago. He has badly twisted the ankle, but he may come back in the second half if needed. The way they're going, I don't think there's going to be too much need. And a substitution coming from the Maccabi bench. Aresti, who gets the applause he deserves, is replaced by Chen Lippin. Lippin, only 18 and a half years old, 6'1", being groomed to take over, so they say, from Mickey Berkovic. So Radovic. Welcome free shots to bring the margin back to respectability. Just under 3 minutes left in this first half. And Berkovic, another attempt. But this time, the Yugoslavs were able to take the rebound. But look how fast Maccabi are getting back into the defensive positions. Very, very quick indeed. And they're not getting the breaks now. Johnson. Silva. Even the big men bringing the ball in now. And Johnson oozing with confidence. Perry being checked out. And the referee's allowing that to go. Radovic. Yes. Oh! Having said yes, it popped out again. So when the luck goes against you, it really goes against you. 45 to 31, 2 minutes and 12 seconds left in this first half. Maccabi in their seventh consecutive final. Rotations, use of screens, an attempt to get closer and closer to the basket. Abdiya saw Johnson in front of him and declares that basket interference. In other words, the basket, the ball was struck on its way down to the basket. And so, therefore, as Scherf, as Vice Scherf, the coach to Maccabi Tel Aviv, obviously didn't agree, the scorebook will show that 2 points. Lippin, defended by Radovic. Johnson. Oh. Well, Johnson was very, very closely defended by Milivoje, but to no avail, 47 to 33. Two to Milivoje, 6'9" forward, number 14. Less than a minute and a half this first half. Maccabi beaten in last year's final by Milan, anxious to get back onto the winner's rostrum once again. Radovic, Silva is back, and Silva did so well. Oh, well played, Radovic. It looked as though Silva had done the job. He must have been very close to a three-second violation there, Radovic. And that's a foul against Radovic. I just have a feeling that Radovic should have been on a good deal earlier in this match. He's making his presence felt.
Last couple of minutes have been a good phase for the Red Star team. They've started to get back into the game a little bit more and getting better shots, but they still must contain Lee Johnson and Ossie Perry close to the basket to have a chance of winning this Phillips tournament.
Milivoje, the long, long pass. Radovic to Nikolic. Oh, an awesome rebound there by Johnson. A foul against Abdiya. Very keen to get in to stop the pass, but found Berkovic there and he couldn't stop. He went straight through him. Second foul against Abdiya. 33 seconds left in this first half. 10 points the margin. So it's still respectable. Berkovic 1-1. If he gets the first one, he'll have a go at the second. Yes. Gives himself the opportunity of a second free shot by scoring the first. That was very, very welcome indeed from Nikolic. Less than 20 seconds left. And the combination of Nikolic and Radovic again beginning to work and pay dividends. Oh, Johnson's in. He's so difficult to stop. And that ring almost came off the backboard. 21 points to Johnson. The long shot attempt to no avail. And the scoreline 50 to 39 at the half. And really, you have to say that it was about Lee Johnson and Kevin McGee. McGee went off, but Perry came on. And those two, along with Lou Silva, with his back to us here, track-suited already, well, they were devastating on the backboards. And I think that Red Star have to get their outside shooting together if they're going to do any good in the second half. So 11 points then to make up. And I wonder what the coach Ranko Zenovica of Yugoslavia has been saying to his team in that changing room at half-time. They have just a little bit of discipline to instill into their play. And the first 5 minutes or so of this half, absolutely vital. And the man who scored that basket, Lee Johnson, had 21 points in the first half and took 10 rebounds. And his early combination with Kevin McGee, formidable. And the news of McGee, McGee will not play again in this match. The ankle that he twisted in that first half, too serious. And one or two fumbles, but Bogosyev comes out, pumps the ball into the big number 13. Oh, and that's two or three times he's missed that inside shot. And that will score 2 points. Johnson popped the ball out, as you saw, didn't allow it to go through. So, Oresti defended by Karadzic. And it's Bogosyev, the number 10, who's got the job of marking Johnson. But Olsi-Peri and an injury to Milicevic, and that looks a bad injury too. Went over on his ankle, and Miki Berkovic too, nearby. Not sure what Berkovic's injury was. It's a knee, it is an ankle too. Both men injured an ankle in that affray. Berkovic looks okay, but the big man that the Yugoslavs have flown in specially for this match hobbles off, as you see, and he too will get, and it doesn't look well. That will need some quick attention. Well, we'll see. Milivoja is on in his place. Milivoja, the number 14. Bogosyev, yes. That was a nice fadeaway shot from Bogosyev. 4 points to him, but and a lost possession by Maccabi. Now, this is a good phase for Radovic. It was so important that Red Star came in with a good first 2 or 3 minutes, and they've done so. And there's a man in agony, as you see. So two men with serious ankle injuries, one from each side. But I don't think there's too much wrong with Johnson.
Just shows the jumping ability of someone 6'10". He just reaches over and puts the ball in.
Speculative shot by Karadzic. Silva. How well Lou Silva's played, Paul. Significant factor, isn't he?
Yes, not only has he been rebounding and scoring, he's also been passing the ball inside, made some beautiful play. Great play for someone who's 6'8" tall.
And that was a foul against Oresti. Ordahai Oresti, the number 7 for Maccabi. That's his first foul. Physical education graduate. Long-time member of this Maccabi team. Man-to-man defence and a nice roll-around, but he was unable to execute, and Johnson's foul, I fancy, and that'll be his third. So Johnson, 28 years old, 6'10", has played in Naples, was in fact the most valuable player in the Italian league last year.
Seems even when the Yugoslavs get the ball close to the basket, they're intimidated by Johnson's jumping ability. They must go up strong and not worry about him and just concentrate on putting the ball in the basket.
Avdija brings that deficit back to 10. Silva on top, defended by Avdija. Silva. Oh! This Israeli support in the audience must be delighted with the man wearing the number 12 vest. So versatile. Oh dear. 3-on-1. An illegal dribble adjudged by Berkovic. Now that was silly because there were 3 men onto 1.
Here he is. Miki Berkovic loses control of the ball and so turns the ball over. He should have made the pass.
Avdija. The rebounder there is Milivoja, and oh dear. Berkovic, Oresti. Bogosyev. Radovic. And the foul against Oresti. Not there soon enough. Second foul. And Radovic now has a free shot opportunity. Two shots. Zadavica, the former Olympic coach for Yugoslavia, coached a Red Star, will be calculating carefully and will be looking at his players on the bench as well as on court to see whether he has the machinery to come back from this 10-point deficit. Olsi Perry fouled by Abdiya. Abdiya's third foul. Number 15 there. 6'7", Abdiya, and he looks short alongside Olsi Perry. Aresti. Aresti defended there by Karadzic. Berkovic is shot short, but the man Johnson is there yet again. A well-played Milivoja, the number 14. Yes. And the ankle being heavily strapped, so his role important, as you will no doubt have already gathered. He'll be back on court shortly. Johnson, 2 points. 27 points to Johnson, 60-50 again, Maccabi lead. The rebound to Olsi Perry. The fast break on, and Silva, the man on the far side, but it's Berkovic who takes it. A nice free break, fast break with the lanes being filled. Abdiya, a very bad miss indeed. Oh. Well, Mr. Johnson.
Here's the pass to Johnson, and he just goes up over people. He gets fouled, and he still scores the 2 points. Incredible play.
Well, the Maccabi players appreciated by their supporters in particular, but by the crowd as a whole, and the Israeli team very slow to go back to their bench, and they're allowing themselves a little smile here and there. They have the advantage, and look at that, it's a 14-point advantage, and I wonder what Mr. Ranko Zadavica can do.
The big problem that Red Star have now is that their big players are totally intimidated by Lee Johnson for Maccabi, and they can't score close to the basket. On top of that, their shooters from outside, away from the basket, cannot score with their jump shots. So Maccabi are getting the rebounds, and they're fast breaking down the other end and just adding to this lead more and more all the time. They've got to do something to try and get back into this game.
I'm surprised they haven't brought Nikolic, the number 6, back on, actually, Red Star, because Nikolic and Radovic, the 6 and 11, were working so well together, and defensively more difficult to defend against, both men shooting from both sides of the court, whereas at the moment they only have the one shooter, Radovic, on there, and they can defend him fairly comfortably. Abdiya, Bogosayev, nice rolling movement.
That's better play from Red Star, getting in more confident with attacking moves to the basket.
With the three-point shot potential now, the margins that we see, which were great last year, not as great this year. Oh, well done, and that's another great rebound by Milivoja. Karadzic, defended by Berkovic. Nice shot. 2 points just inside the arc, and there's one of our shooting players, Radovic. 14 points to Radovic. Aresti just calling the play, verbally and by signal. Silva. Double dribble, yes. An illegal dribble by Aresti. A long pass cut out by Silva, but knocked off court by Berkovic, and that should go to Red Star, and it does.
It'll be important for Red Star to score here to narrow the gap to 9 points. They really need a basket right here.
This would make the game very, very interesting indeed if this goes in. It has. And it was Milivoja, Alexander Milivoja, at 6'9". He's had a good second half. 14 minutes and 6 seconds left in this final. Aresti, defended by Stratenovic. Oh. Olsi Perry, 4 points to his credit. Nice play. Aresti. Kosti Berkovic. Oh, that fast-running shot. The shot on the move from Berkovic is so often successful. And the margin now 13 points. Radovic, Bogosayev, Abdiya. And that was better from Abdiya. He's been stifled by the defending players of Maccabi. If only he could get one or two. A foul against Oresti. And coach Zweischerf up on his feet. And I can't begin to explain what he said to the referee.
Referee here adjudged that Matti Oresti took away the arm from the player, although from this angle it looks like he hit the ball. No wonder the crowd are moaning.
I think he was unlucky, but Bogosayev has just put two more points onto the Red Star score sheet. 10 points the margin now. A turnover, a steal, a rundown, a fast break, a couple of quick baskets, and it would all change. Silva's long, long shot again. Johnson. Bogosayev. Good. Silva back again. And that was good play by Maccabi. Oh! Olsi Perry. Berkovic to Perry. Marvellous understanding.
It's a lovely fake from Mickey Berkovic, making it very easy for Olsi Perry to lay the ball up.
Stratinovic, 2 points. Back to 10, and almost a steal. Oh, and a good check. Well played there, Abdiya. Oh, foul, surely, against Olsi Perry. Quick to acknowledge the expressionless face of Olsi Perry. And we've got substitution coming at the first opportunity. This is a provisional. If the shot is successful, then the substitution can be made. So let's see if the next shot is good. Oh, and Radovic missed both. Well, that will they'll pay dearly for that. Berkovic. Well, Berkovic, who's been quiet in previous matches, has come good here, making his presence felt. 21 points to his credit.
Right now, when Red Star miss a shot, Maccabi are so quick, they're always scoring down the other end. So Red Star are going, in fact, 4 points behind. Two that they should have scored, and two that Maccabi are scoring.
Well, that was 2 points to Abdiya. But they're so dominant on the backboards, and so they're getting possession of the ball in defence all the time, so that the front runners, as I said before, are able to be halfway down the court before the ball is actually in the possession of the Israeli team. Oh, well done to Milivoje. Well, Johnson on 32 points as the substitutes wait to come onto court. Milicevic obviously repaired, and here he comes. And we'll see how that injury stands up to the intensity of play. There doesn't seem to be too much of a limp there at the moment. But thankfully, he's OK. Bogosayev leaves, and surprisingly, Radovic has left. But Nikolic is back on. Oh, well, rebound. Well, that's the first touch on the ball. Nikolic, number nine on top, Karadzic. 10.5 minutes left, and the foul against Berkovic there, his third. So clear evidence of the demise of Kevin McGee. He is sitting on the bench as that basket is scored. There he is. Badly injured ankle. Silva. Oh, Johnson just for once lost possession. And everybody who supports Red Star Belgrade, a sigh of relief there. Nikolic. Avdija. Avdija defended by Silva. Silva opting for the pass. Karadzic using his screen. Oh, Silva stipping the ball away. But that was Milicevic. 11 in the 11th minute, 9 minutes and 52 seconds left. 77 to 70, and that is the shortest margin for some considerable time. 7 points then. So Red Star Belgrade back in this game. And that's a foul against Milicevic. It's first foul of the match. And instructions always being shouted onto court by Zelovica. Coached Yugoslavia on more than 300 occasions, culminating in that marvellous Olympic gold medal in Moscow. Silva, defended by Avdija. Aresti. Johnson couldn't collect that. The turnover, just what Red Star wanted. Now, this must go in. Avdija. Karadzic. Milicevic deep in now, marked by Johnson. Yes, and that's Nikolic, the captain. And look at that, now 5 points down, Red Star. 8 minutes and 58 seconds left in this World Club Invitation Tournament. Aresti. Yes, and the response quick. But the fast break now going well. Unfortunately, Mirovosha was clear in the forecourt there, but the pass didn't come in, and so the big Maccabi players were back in defence. Aresti tightly defending Karadzic. Man-to-man defence. Good play. Good play indeed. Nikolic. Marvellous stuff. Now, this is much better. And now a little bit of pressure on Maccabi, the first pressure of this final, really.
Okay, now, we are coming to the set game. Try to move, pick each other, and we have to move from one ball, from one side to the other. Take a good shot, not from the side, but strong, high, take your easy shot. Now, let's go back to defense and move over picks.
Let's run them one, Mickey. Patience, let's run them one with patience. With patience, Mickey.
It's a good time out there from Maccabi Tel Aviv. The coach is telling them to be patient when they attack and to get the ball inside close to the basket. Get the ball to Lee Johnson and Olsi Perry close to the basket. And defensively, they must get out to the shooters, particularly number 6, Nikolic, stop him from making that shot so they can get the rebound and fast break again. So, Perry, Aresti, marked on the far side by Karadzic. Aresti. Johnson. Johnson's been quiet over the last couple of minutes or so. Aresti. Berkovic looking for the shot, but well pressured. Oh, Johnson has it. Aresti. Good discipline, sending the ball out. Berkovic. And there's a foul. And who's it against? It's against the number 13 again, I think. That's his second. It's against Milicevic, the injured player back on. 6'10" of him. Just to remind you, he's just flown in from the Balkan Games in Athens, representing the Yugoslavian national team. Hasn't played in any other game in this tournament. Just here for the final. Miki Berkovic. Yes. 23 points to him. Now, this shot, very, very important indeed. Control, look for the open basket, and the missed shot, and Berkovic in full flight. Silva's there. Johnson asking for the foul, not getting it, but getting his 2 points. Hear how Lee Johnson protects the ball with his body and he just flips the ball up into the basket.
Good use of the backboard there. But that margin is back to 9 points. Nikolic pushed out a little there by Berkovic. Avdija looking for the shot in the middle, getting it, but it's too hard. Now this is a running phase for Maccabi. And the next time Red Star must slow down the play. They must slow it down if the fast break isn't on straight away. Oh, well, he's got that in. Had they missed that, that might have been a very, very difficult one to live with.
That was a nice penetration move there, and then just shoots it off the backboard, rolls around the rim and goes in.
Now, Oresti has slowed it down when really the Israeli attack was going well. But still, they are a control ball team when they want to be. Johnson. Oh. In fact, that's Olsi Perry, not Johnson. 8 points to him, 6 minutes and 10 seconds left. 85 to 76. Yes, good shot from Nikolic. The oldest member of the team at 25, so lots of time to go for this Yugoslav side. Oresti. Johnson now playing way out, defended by Mika Milicevic. Karadzic. Avdija, but Silva played so well to get the get into the defending position. It was left to Milivoja to finish off the point.
Good defense from Lou Silva, but there's a tip in from the other big Yugoslav center.
5 minutes and 25 left in this final. 5 points the margin now. A couple of steals. And a three-pointer from outside. Perry defended. Oh. Well, I think the foul came first.
There's the strength of Maccabi. One player gets his shot blocked. But then Lee Johnson just goes up and dunks the ball home for 2 points. He gets fouled. So that's a three-point play. Now there's a seven-point gap with a chance to make it eight.
And there is the eight. And Avdija. In committing that foul, moves on to four personal fouls. Avdija wearing the number 15 best of Red Star Belgrade. Milivoja, Nikolic. The big Yugoslavs having great difficulty in getting inside. They don't come up against too many sides that are this big and can jump this well.
It's also interesting to see whenever Maccabi need a basket, they go inside, very close to the basket, to their big men, to draw fouls and to get easier shots.
Olsi Perry. So difficult to contain. When you're trying to contain Johnson and then Perry begins to play like this, where do you go from there? No, and there's no rebound power on the near side either. That's the pressure shot. And really, if anything, the Yugoslavs mustn't take the pressure shots. They are the ones that have to control their play now. If the fast break isn't on, and they must work their way in, because the margin is back to 10. Johnson and Silva. Oh, Oresti, and the crowd loving that. And then you get an opportunity of the break. They're struggling to get every single opportunity when perhaps normally they wouldn't have gone for that. It was a little bit too much to expect. And they give away possession once more, and the margin is 12. 3 minutes and 44 seconds left in this final. One of the steals that's required. Three on one. Oh, that's a very nasty collision indeed, hence the padding on that upright at the back. But it looks as though Berkovic went onto the metal surround with his hip, and that was quite nasty.
Just see there, the pass comes to Nikolic, and as he comes in, Mickey Berkovic mistimes and hits him with his body, and both players fall to the floor. think Miki Berkovic hit himself against the upright of the backboard.
Well, that was a foul against Miki Berkovic, as well as the slight injury, and that's his fourth. But still 3.5 minutes left, 92-80 the score.
I really think that the Yugoslavs should look to press now to try and defend further away from the basket and try and get a couple of steals and make Maccabi hurry. At the moment, they're taking their time and they really need to close this gap more quickly than they are doing at the moment.
14 points now to Nikolic, number 6 for Yugoslavia, for Red Star Belgrade. 10 points. Silva, and what a superb game Lou Silva's had. And that's an off-the-ball foul, attempting to get into a good defensive position. Milicevic takes his third foul. That's the big number 13.
That's the kind of effect that a big player, a very good big player like Lee Johnson, has on a team. They try and defend him closely and start to hold him, and then the referee's called a foul. So that's the great advantage of having a good big man.
Oh, well, just for once, an error. Nikolic, Milicevic, Karadzic into Avdija. Avdija. There's no penetration yet. They can't get inside, and the shot must be successful, and it is. The rebound potential just wasn't there if that ball had missed. That was Karadzic. 2.5 minutes, just over. 92-84. A maximum work now from Red Star in this final. And the favourites are number 1 seeds, leading the number 4 seeds, who almost didn't qualify. But Johnson, 40 points now to Lee Johnson. Oh, nice play. Milivoja. Milivoja has been kept fairly quiet in attack. Oh! And Milivoja, in defence, though, is very aggressive indeed, and just raises his hand to acknowledge that foul. That's his second foul overall, and just looking at the scoreboard now, 94-86, 2 minutes and 10 seconds left.
There's an example right there of how mobile Lee Johnson is. 1 minute he's down defensive end trying to get rebounds, the other end he's running up trying to get a long pass to score on a fast break.
And he can hit free shots too. Last year, the crowd here watched Maccabi beaten by Milan. But this year, despite that success, it's a very different story at the moment. 96-88. Under 2 minutes left in this Phillips Championship final. Silva. What talent there is. In last year's final, well, he was nowhere in it, but this year this crowd have something to cheer about. Karadzic, number 6, Nikolic in the middle, deep, marked by Berkovic. Nikolic, 2 points to him.
I'm surprised that Nikolic sat out most of the first half. He really should have been in there playing. He's keeping Red Star in the game right now.
And I'm surprised that, as we've said several times, that Radovic isn't there too. Oh, yes, Avdija. If only he can go. Yes, well played, Avdija. But Johnson went all the way with him and was just a matter of inches away from
Avdija
stopping it.
Avdija got that ball, and he was making sure that went through. But look at Lee Johnson, so very close to blocking that dunk shot.
45 seconds left. Silva, marked by Avdija. Aresti. Oh, a steal. Karadzic. Karadzic, 2 more points. 98-94. Now, with 29 seconds left, the timeout has been called. And remember, a steal and a couple of shots, and that can make all the difference. And 30 seconds is an awful long time left to play. Now, Red Star still have a chance.
We got 29 seconds. We are playing four corners. Limitations field, Vicky, Morty. Be careful not to dribble. Now, if a player is stopping his dribble, came to him. Okay, and move, move. No shot. If you miss the ball, don't make a foul on the shot.
Coach there is telling the Maccabi players that Red Star are going to press everywhere to try and get the basketball. When they get the ball over the half court, they're going to spread out, pass the ball for the whole 29 seconds. They're allowed to do that, and no shot. So they keep hold of the ball, so Red Star can't get a chance to score.
Now, there's the press. Double team, but Berkovic gets possession. And they're not going to hurry the shot here. There's no need for them to hurry. Silva marked by Abdiya, and he's fouled by Abdiya. That's Abdiya's fifth foul. I think you'll see the Reds marker go up on the table. Yes, it does.
This one-on-one shot from Lu Silva now could be crucial. If he gets the first shot, then he'll get a second. But if he misses this and Red Star get the rebound, they have a chance to come down and score and narrow the gap further. And there's still 16 seconds to play.
I'm surprised they didn't take the possession, actually, with just 16 seconds left. He has missed it. Now. It's in. And we've got 2 points with 4 seconds left, 6 seconds left. 2 points between the sides. Now, can we steal again, Red Star? It's gone, surely. It's gone. And Maccabi are the champions, but only just. My goodness me, what a play at the end from Red Star Belgrade. They only lost it by two. Just imagine, had the press gone on that few minutes earlier, what a difference it might have made. Mickey Berkovic played so well for Maccabi Tel Aviv, but what about Lee Johnson in the center of your picture now? 42 points and 12 rebounds. That is a marvelous performance all round. They lost Kevin McGee early on, but that didn't matter because Olsi Perry came on to play well too. But Nikolic for Red Star Belgrade, well, he played so well. He'd missed only one shot in the second half and scored 18 points and defended so well. But the Red Star team may well have assessed Luis Silva's performance too, because that was marvelous.